Good morning, all of you. It's very important to play in open tournaments also. You play on your age group, it's important, but also play with the higher age group, that is also important. You know, one of the secrets of Vishwanathan Anand, he rarely played the age group tournaments. He mainly concentrated from senior nationals. When he was national sub-junior champion, he said, I'm going to play in the national B and national A and national senior championship. And that is where he was able to defeat Manuel Aaron, one of the national champions. Try to aim at very big, try to become like Vishwanathan Anand. What is the secret of Vishwanathan Anand's success? He was the first one to realize that mistakes are all there waiting for you to be made, and so are the combinations. So you need to spot both the mistakes available in the position and also the combination. So avoid the mistakes and find out the combination. Very important. So if you lose a game, you have to find out what went wrong, what mistake did you make. The game of chess cannot be lost or won without a mistake. If you make a mistake, opponent wins. If opponent makes a mistake, you win. Okay? So always try to find out what went wrong and try to be better than yourself every day. If you are at a particular rating today, after 3 months you should be at a higher rating. And after 6 months you should be at an even higher rating. That is the way to success. And all the best to all of you. Wish you good luck, and let us create among you at least one Vishwanathan Anand, the world champion. Okay? Round 3 opens, you can start your applause. Please. Start your applause. All the best to all of you. Leading players in the 60s and 70s, they played, and I was the school boy, teenager. So, but yet I was able to make a draw against him, and nobody else was able to. When a national champion lost and India number 2 lost, and I was able to make a draw, although I was not a strong player. So that is because I had grasped the idea of chess, that is, no one can beat me if I don't make a mistake. You can go back and analyze the games and you will see that you made a mistake. The things were made easy because you made mistakes. Game of chess is such that if you don't make a mistake, even the world champion can't beat you. And that aspect you have to remember. And you have to reduce your making of your mistakes. When you win a game or lose a game, when you lose, you have to find out what went wrong with your plan. When you win a game, you don't have to believe that you are a genius or something. Your opponent has made a mistake. You could be a genius, but a game is lost only because your opponent has made a mistake. You can be a reasonably good badminton player or table tennis player in 3 months, but to be a reasonably good chess player, you need 3 years' time. That is because it's impossible for that to sustain your concentration, attention and alertness for a period of 40 minutes or 30 minutes, 35 minutes. So from parents' point of view also, perhaps the result could be really disappointing, but that is because children are young and the thinking process is going on. So I wish good luck for all.
I think it is wonderful being at the Elpro Sports Festival and Elpro International School. A chess tournament which began today, I think it was very interesting. I played with some of the kids. And the chess is a game which originated in India, and yet it's played in more than 195 countries now. Most important is a lot of study has been made on game of chess and how it helps developing a personality. And the results are really amazing. The Western countries, the developed countries, have all introduced chess as a compulsory subject in their curriculum because it makes you more intelligent, it improves your IQ, it improves your concentration power, it improves your reason, just logical thinking, and basically it also calms you down. The hyperactive children are officially asked to play game of chess to get rid of their impulsive behavior. Chess also prevents aging of cells for, and it's used to prevent Alzheimer's or Parkinson's disease. And becoming a chess player is always beneficial. It's a win-win situation. If a child is playing for a professional cause to win in a tournament, then of course different qualities are required. The parent has to monitor the child on a regular basis. One good way of ensuring that the parents are one good way of ensuring that the child is doing well is to compare the child with what child was 3 months back. If the child is improving international rating or any other ratings, good. And if the child is not improving, then I think it's the time to take a call. Parent must intervene. There are two ways of looking at monitoring at it. The technical part your chess teacher is going to monitor. So parents are not to interfere in the technical part. At the same time, the monitoring part, which the professional chess teacher is not going to be able to do it. So you have to do it. You have to make sure that your child is continuously improving, and the child is also enjoying the game, enjoying the training session. And the child should have an urge to play the game competitively. You must make them participate in various tournaments. And of course, most important thing is the independent thinking. Chess does develop independent thinking in a child, and they are able to make use of it in the personal life. At the same time, playing fast chess, the rapid chess, blitz chess, it's not something that is recommended. You must have seen top chess players condemning rapid chess and blitz chess and faster games. Chess is a game where one has to think first and act. So make sure that your child plays classical chess, and also when they are dealing with life, life is also very similar to chess. So treat the life as a game of chess, and treat the game of chess as an actual life, and your child will be very successful.